All right, cum guzzlers, welcome back. So today we're going over some radios that I got. I got the old one for the girls' four-wheeler, and got this little piece of shit for mine. So we're going to see today what y'all think, what I think, whether cheaper equals better. Yeah, no, that ain't happening. I ain't going to fucking spill it. So this is a Boss. The RGB ATV 30 something something, I don't know, but what I do know is it's got all kinds of fucking lights and speakers and strobe lights and all kinds of hokey doke bullshit on it. Picked this up for, I believe, off the Jungle website for $156. No, it was not off there, it was off somewhere else. We got it on sale pretty good. And I think these are going for now, like, damn near $299, $180, somewhere in there. They're pretty fucking expensive. But we caught this on sale, so we got it for her. Now, over here, we got the old W. Kinger Amazon Jungle Book Special. And this was $75, and we got it for mine. Now, both sound bars are secured with straps. I got these little, it's like the little cam buckle straps holding them down. And then this one, the boss one, comes with its own straps and all that good shit. Now, that one, literally, it's its own standalone thing, comes on and off, Bluetooth, does all its stuff, and it's you can recharge it on the back here. And it's got like an SD card slot and USB-C and regular USB and an aux port on it. And it comes with, let me see here. Yeah, it comes with a little aux to USB-C. Or excuse me, USB to USB-C, my fault. And then comes with an aux cord as well that you can use for it. So, It's pretty good. I like it so far. We're gonna try her here in a little bit. Now we're gonna start with the Boss first though, and this one, it comes with cigarette plugs and all that silly shit. And this one I've got hardwired to her battery. It's strapped to the thing, so it opens up nice and easy still, where you can get down into here. I've got right down here, I think, yeah, you can kind of see it. I've got a little 15 amp circuit breaker, or fuse, excuse me, with that wired in. And then I cut away some of the plastic here so that way the charge cord can sneak up and out and works and everything while the lid's down. And I've got the, it comes with the cord here, so you've got a remote control for it here where it hooks on to the handlebar. It came with brackets and shit, and I didn't like the brackets the way they had them, so I modified them onto the clamp here and bent and made it. And then also I've got it kind of folded down in here, but it's got an auxiliary port here that you can, you know, put in wherever you got. But it comes automatic. Originally it comes set up with a cigarette plug, and I really didn't like the cigarette plug because anytime you got shit like that, water and moisture and mud and all that can get in there. So I hardwired it with these style connectors, and all my quads and most of my shit in my shop has got these on it. And I've got battery tenders that I use. I've got like two battery tenders, and I just kind of rotate them out. Like I'll have the tractor on the battery tender for 1 week and the quad on one, and then, you know, I just kind of rotate shit out. So this is already a good 12 volt supply, and it seals up nicely, you know, where it's male, female, and easy enough to undo. If something starts shorting out and melting the fuck down, you can unplug it real easy. So let me close this up here, and we'll plug her in and show you guys what we got here. Yeah, that's, all right, that's good. It comes on green automatically. Now, once you hold the play button, it freaking talks and does kinds of silly shit. And right, so once you get going, I don't know if y'all can see it, but that little Bluetooth thing, you push and hold that and it starts flashing, and then you pair your phone up to it, and then you can just throw your phone in the daggone you know, in a waterproof box or whatever like that. That's what she does with hers. Yep, there we go, Willie. So now we're hooked up. And she just puts her phone down in this nice little Yeti tote and keeps it nice and dry and everything. So it works pretty good. Let's get some music on here. So you can set it up for a bunch of different flash patterns. It's got a little remote with it. And you can keep it or whatever like that. And then if you just want to pause it, you push that button there, that'll pause it. Push it again, it'll skip play. And if you push and hold it, it'll turn the volume up. And I mean, it gets pretty loud. And when you hear it do that, that lets you know it's the top sound. And if you push it once, it'll skip tracks. Pretty good. That phone that I got there is on the house Wi-Fi, and it don't reach out here real good. So we're gonna start up and
Oh yeah!
There you go, Willie.
It was this blind man, right? He was feeling his way down the street with this stick, right?
Yeah.
Hey, he walked past this fish market. You know what I'm saying? He stopped into the deep.
So you can Good morning, ladies. So it works pretty good, and you can hear it well too.
I tell you what, all I need on the guitar. Hey, pull on the drum. Hey, everybody, try to.
It's pretty loud. It's really loud. It's not got a ton of bass, which you don't want that, because if you got that, then you can't fucking hear it. But it's waterproof. I power washed it the other day. I didn't put the power washer right on it, obviously, but you know, it worked pretty good. But I mean, you can hear it clear as a bell when you're riding. And I guess I might as well talk about this little Yeti box here. So this, we bought this for my wife's four-wheeler. She really wanted something to put all her snacks and sodas, and you know, like, obviously it's not a cooler by any means, but it's a nice super waterproof box. We had looked at some different waterproof boxes that they offer, but for this Hawkeye, where it's so small, it was hard to find anything that was going to be the right size. And then even if you found one, they really weren't that waterproof when I heard. But this thing, on the other hand, this bitch is 100% totally waterproof. I took the power washer and literally blasted it, and not a drop got in this sumbitch. So it's pretty good. It's built tough. The latches are kind of silly. They seem to hold, and when they snap good, but you got to definitely watch these latches. Not the biggest fan of those. My wife don't really like them either. But it's got a bunch of little bags and pouches, got a couple bins, a divider, stuff like that. But it's a good little box, and you know, we've got it, you know, same kind of thing. Got the cam buckle straps on here holding it to the back, and it's on here and not going no fucking where. Definitely was expensive, but on the other hand, you know, I think it was like $230 or something like that. But for a nice, like, you know, back seat, back rack box for a quad, that's pretty much what they're going for. And they're not even waterproof. So I wanted to make sure we got something that was waterproof and that was small and not like dwarf the size of the four-wheeler. I mean, with the freaking speaker on this thing anyway, it's just way too fucking much for this little thing. But she rides around, has a good time, and, you know, that's all that fucking matters. But she likes it, and shit, the other day she was listening to that damn thing in the yard by herself, getting drunk on Twisted Tees, riding around the fucking yard all day. I'm pretty sure our neighbors, like, two houses up and two houses down, her wet ass pussy by fucking Cardi B playing on that son of a bitch. So, hey, whatever. That's what floats her boat. So, hey, you gotta do what you gotta do to make her happy. I was able to buy that instead of buying her a new one. So, you know, fuck it. If that's what I gotta do to make her happy, listen to me. Make your woman happy and she will make you happy. Now, over here for the W King. So now this thing is its own standalone unit. It doesn't have a remote or nothing like that. You literally just turn it on, hook her up, and go. Cool thing about it, though, is, and I was pretty tickled about this, so the you can charge it while it's playing. Some people said you can't, but what I had it, it would charge up. So let's see here. Now, this is definitely not as loud as that Boss, which, of course, it's not. The Boss is a really nice fucking thing. And if this little piece of shit was louder and sounded better, then I'd be a mad motherfucker. But, yeah, so you can see right now it's charging. It's blinking. We're going to go ahead. Let's turn her on here. You just push and hold the button, and it comes on. And then... All right, so yeah, you push and hold. That's like the equalizer thing and all that. You kind of push and hold that, and then she'll start flashing blue. And then you just hook your phone up to her, and she's good to go. And it kind of gives you a little tooty-toot tone thing there and lets you know. So let's go back. And as you can see, it's still charging and working. So it's flashing there, letting you know it's charging. Everything's good. So that's awesome that you can be charging and riding and playing at the same time. So, all right, there we go. So, you can... When it goes quiet like that, it lets you know that it's all the way up. I think. Maybe that changes the song. So that lets you know that little blank. Because it cuts through everything and it works pretty good. And if you hold the plus or the negative button, it'll change the song, and the button on the right's different equalizer things for you. And then of course the play button in the middle will pause it. But yeah, it's pretty good. It seems to be well built. I read some other reviews and seen some guys that done some sound testing on it, and it seems to be good. It's supposed to be waterproof. You know, it ain't gonna be like submarine proof or whatever, but I don't intend to, you know, get all that deep with this thing anyway. But you can pretty well hear it over over the noise of everything of the four-wheeler and all. Like I said, you ain't gonna freaking blast everybody out of the water, but I'm not one of them people that likes to freaking, you know, be an asshole riding around blasting super loud music anyway. But it's got like a metal, you can hear it, an actual metal grill on it and everything. And it's got a bass speaker here on the side and another one over here as well. But it seems to be well made. We'll see. I've not power washed this one yet, but we'll see how it handles that. And, you know, like I said, I just use my little Harbor Junk one. And they seem to hold up well, so we'll see. But, yeah, so we're about ready to go to Busco. I think, you know, really getting them, getting these little tugger tails. That's what I'm calling them from now on, tugger tails. I know they make the tiger tail thing that reels back in, but I call it a tugger tail. That's a Johnny Crash Customs, you know, Johnny Crash Customs patented, you know, don't fucking steal it. It's like, fuck that shit. Y'all want it, take it. Great idea. It'll work. It worked for me. It'll work for you. But fuck yeah, get you a tugger tail, build you one up like a fucking man, and you'll be good to go. So, yeah, I got a, and if you want to check it out, I got a video about how I made these tugger tails, what they're made out of. And if you want to check that out, go down on the channel, check her out. I ain't got many videos yet, so check it out, search it up on the channel, and it'll show you right there where it is. I'll have her in there. And then I also made up out of some old ratchet straps, made up some tree savers and shit like that. Y'all take it easy, stay classy, and don't do nothing I wouldn't do. And if you do, make sure you get a fucking video.